Hey, what's going on, guys? Omar here, bringing you guys another Smpl video. And today I have Smpl Dark, aka Rob.
What is up, you guys? Robin here.
And the newcomer, Smpl Ozzy, aka Billy.
I'm Australian.
And today we're bringing you guys some Call of Duty news. We're actually going to be talking about the rumors of the new Call of Duty. And so the first question is going to be, what do you think of the rumor of the new Call of Duty being in space? And we'll start off with Billy. Billy, what do you think about that?
Honestly, I fucking hate the idea. I wanted just to go back to the Modern Warfare shit. Oh, fuck behind us. Just Modern Warfare games in general. They were fucking good games.
I totally agree with that. What about you, Rob?
It has been a very, very long time since we've had a Call of Duty strictly on ground, and for us to go back to space is just taking a step in the wrong direction. I feel like Call of Duty needs to go back to where it was made originally, back onto the floor without any of this spacious shit going on. That's just my opinion.
You know what? I agree with you guys. I really don't like the idea of space. I feel like the game would get boring really fast. It's just, I don't know. I don't think it's the right thing to do. I don't know about it. You know, it's just,
yeah.
I think they're just making it just because they're running out of ideas. God damn it. But that's just me. Fuck. Yeah, so, oh, sorry, I just like super died right now. But yeah, that's,
Let's play devil's advocate here. Like, what would make it an okay game? What would the space part of it be okay?
Like, what would be the pros and cons, basically?
Space warfare.
Yeah, like, what would be okay about it being in space, you know?
Billy, what do you think?
Then it wouldn't be space warfare, but then it wouldn't be Call of Duty, because like you'll be in jets and shit all the time, fighting each other and whatnot.
And haven't we been in jets for like the last 2 years? With advanced warfare?
Really. We've been in Harriers for a short amount of time. We haven't been in jets.
Oh, okay, like
jets.
The outside. Okay, no, I know what you're talking about. I agree.
Yeah, I agree too.
How about you, Omar? What do you think?
To me, I feel like it'd be super slow. And if they wouldn't make it slow, what are they gonna add? What do you guys think of if it's not gonna be slow? What do you think they're gonna add in space? Take a guess. I mean, they're gonna add the fucking booster. Yeah, see, exactly. And it's three. What? This is the third year already. What? Black Ops 2 with the booster? No. No, second. And that's kind of bull, dude. You know, it's just I can't handle
we've been
the booster
the same game. Yeah, we've been having the same game for the last 2 years, and to make it three, it's like
pretty much
you're just eating too much of the same flavored cake, you know?
Yeah, I totally agree.
I don't agree about the eating the same flavor kind of cake, though.
What, so you would eat chocolate cake every single day?
Fuck yeah.
Oh my god. Probably an Australian thing.
I ain't gonna lie, I like marble cake, you know, that's pretty delicious. I ain't gonna lie. I would eat that every day. Same flavor shit.
Anyway, moving on.
Alright, moving on. Second question. So this is new. I actually just found this out from Billy. And the question is, do you think the new 3-year gap for Call of Duty would be good for the series?
3-year gap as in the new developer every year?
Every 3 years as a developer, new developer.
Okay. Yeah.
Is this where I start this one, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
So yeah, Robin, do you want to start this one off or?
Well, yeah, I'd love to. I think I like this question a lot.
All right, go ahead, go kick it off for us. All
right. I personally love the fact that 3 developers are now developing each Call of Duty. It gives every developer enough time to really flesh out the ideas and actually develop the game into something the fans want. Even though, if the rumors are going to be true, Infinity Ward is going to go something with spacey and That's something the fans don't want. But the 3-year gap gives the developers a chance to get input from the fans, which is always good because you don't want the same game over and over and over again, and having different developers, having different looks makes the game different in a way. That's my take on it.
Yeah. The 3-year gap for me, I think is great. Me personally, I love the idea. It gets people to give new ideas, give the developers new ideas for the new Call of Duties, and to improve the graphics. Even though some of the latest Call of Duties, the graphics have been looking pretty sexy, but this gives them a chance to make them even look better. Let them add new things, new features. I love the idea of the 3-year gap. What sucks is, you know, when you beat the Call of Duty, when the new 3-year gap comes, when you beat the Call of Duty, what are you gonna do for 3 years? They're gonna have what, DLC for 3 years?
I'm pretty sure the second developer is gonna do it. Like, there's three different developers making Call of Duty.
There's gonna be a new Call of Duty every year, basically. It's just that the developers change every year.
Okay.
There's a 3-year gap in between.
It's not gonna be one Call of Duty every 3 years. Holy shit!
I was about to say.
Oh my god.
Oh shit! I'm dead. Yeah, that's okay.
I would go mad, bro. I'd be like clawing my eyes out. Could you imagine if we had Advanced Warfare for 3 years in a row, dude?
Oh fuck. That's what I was thinking. That's how I'm like, up. Whoa. All right, go ahead, Billy.
Well, how about you, Billy?
I think it's not the best of idea because if one game does good, they're all going to try and copy that game.
But so they copy...
They're all going to try and make the same game. Yeah, they're copying...
But look at Advanced Warfare and Black Ops. It's basically the same game.
Yeah, exactly. That Advanced Warfare, people liked it a little here and there, not much. And Black Ops said, oh, maybe we can do this better. And they did. Well, they did, but... Not that much. So they're just gonna try and like copy each other's ideas. They're not gonna try and get a new idea from fucking like they're not gonna start off a new idea. They're gonna try and copy what's already doing well. If you know what I mean.
Yeah. No, I can see where you're going from that. It's like with the boosters and stuff like that. They took it from Advanced Warfare and minimalized it, and they said that that's better. Is that what you're talking about?
Basically.
Yeah,
I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
Oh, there's a sentry fuck.
Yeah, I totally get that. I think.
Yeah,
because the game, Advanced Warfare and Black Ops 3, is pretty similar if you think about it. Just the movements kind of change. But
yeah,
I agree in some way about that.
Oh, the question is, what would you like to see incorporated in the new Call of Duty? So I'm gonna go ahead and start this off. Is that okay with you guys?
Go ahead.
All right. So
The
thing that I would love to see incorporated in the new Call of Duty would be in multiplayer. Would be to be able to fly planes, drive cars, and stuff like that. I would love. For them to put that in the game, oh my god, that would be amazing.
Okay,
like,
why?
Why? Because that would change.
Fucking amazing.
Yeah, that would change the game forever. It would change the series.
It wouldn't be COD.
Yeah.
It wouldn't be COD, though.
Yeah, it would. It would be COD. What are you talking? Oh, god damn it. But it would be amazing just to have all that stuff. They add, like, okay, so they add all this whole futuristic shit, you know, to Black Ops 3, Advanced Warfare. You know, they added all the new vehicles, but you can't do shit with them. You can't do shit. Why would you do that? Why would you add all these... Oh, Jesus Christ. Why would you add all these vehicles in the game? You're only in the story mode where you can't even use it in multiplayer.
Single player.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know what you mean. Like, get the single player thing working in multiplayer.
Yeah. That would be amazing. To me, that would be fucking absolutely fantastic for them to incorporate that. Just to be able to fly jets... Huh?
So if they incorporated the cars and the jets, would you buy it for sure, regardless of it being
Oh my god. Space? Yes, I would. I would definitely buy it. I would definitely. Right. Man, you fucking fly a fucking space jet? Oh my god. Yes. I'm sold. just
right, Billy,
just
what do you think? What do you think, Billy? What would you incorporate?
I've got no idea. I'll probably fucking incorporate something. Like, vintage mode. So, like, you could play shit like in Modern Warfare. But, because I fucking love those games. They're my favorite games by far. So, if they could, like, make a Modern Warfare type mode, I'm pretty sure they've already got one in here, but it's very poorly made. That would be pretty good for multiplayer.
Ooh, so, like, that would be good.
There's limited kill streaks and shit like that, and there's limited gun customizations and whatnot, like in COD 4. That would be cool.
That would be pretty cool, though. Alright, Rob, what about you?
Alright, well, for me, you guys touched on multiplayer. I want to see a really good story mode. I think that the story mode in the last couple years have been very, very lackluster. There hasn't been a story mode like Modern Warfare. The Modern Warfare series, oh my god, that's the reason why I bought the fucking game, bro, because of the story.
Yeah.
So like, go ahead.
I didn't have multiplayer when I bought the first Call of Duty I got. I had fucking, like, I was single player only at the time, so when I fucking got multiplayer, that was awesome. But the single player, I played a shit ton. I'm pretty sure I'm like, I just have to do the co-op missions and I've platinumed the game. That's how much I played that game.
Yeah, no, exactly. That's all that I had because I couldn't get multiplayer on Xbox for some reason. So I just replayed the story mode over and over and over again. And for the last year, in the last 2 years, the story mode hasn't been the best, you know, like, regardless of the game, the graphics being sexy or whatever, the story mode is just complete shit. So I want them to really have a good fucking story mode. Please, I don't give a shit if you put aliens or whatever, do it Infinity Ward, but please just make a goddamn good story so that I can remember and just play it over and over again.
We need characters like Soap and shit, that.
Oh my god, yes! Oh my god! Oh my god, that would be amazing.
Remember all the characters. Soap, Pride.
Oh, I died.
Ghost.
Fuck, I fell down.
Those done.
Ghost is my favorite of all time. That. Oh my god. You guys mind if I add another one? I don't know if you guys agree with me on this one. I think another thing that would be pretty cool is if it's third person. A third person Call of Duty.
Really?
Yes, dude. I feel like that would be amazing. I think that's pretty cool. What do you think?
I don't know.
I don't know about that. Can't you play Halo in third person?
I don't know. I don't think you can. I don't know. I really don't know.
No, I don't know. Yeah. You might be able to.
Well, for me, that would be RPGs, right? That would fall into the RPG category.
Category, yeah. Right.
Yeah. So.
SOCOM was not RPG, and it was third person. That game was amazing for PS3.
Yeah, because RPGs fucking level up you guy, do shit like that and whatnot, like fucking Fallout.
Yeah,
basically.
Wait, did Fallout have a third person? I don't even remember.
Fallout is third person. It's third and first person.
Yeah.
So no, you guys wouldn't want to play it if they added the third person? What?
I wouldn't. It would eliminate the whole concept of Call of Duty being a first person shooter.
Yeah, the fact that you could peek around corners, then that would just give a disadvantage.
Yeah, that's true.
That life of lungs. That would just help campers down in long run.
I've also never been a fan of RPGs, so that would just make me not want to play. All right, so I have a question for you guys. What would your reaction be if Infinity Ward puts aliens as the bad guys in the game, making Call of Duty totally sci-fi?
Yeah, make it like fucking Halo. I don't know about that. I don't.
Oh,
even though people say Halo is a really good game, I don't know if it's my sort of game. But then again, Call of Duty is not really my game, but I still play it a shit ton. It's fucking fun. even though I don't like that towards the start of the game. So,
how about you,
I'm Mark? Really on the edge of that.
For me... Oh, fuck. I don't know, to be honest. If it's going to be just a super sci-fi game, why not just buy Destiny 2 when it comes out? Or just play the regular Destiny?
Yeah.
So, I don't know, man. Okay. Just... Well, that's just me, too, because I'm not really into sci-fi games.
Which is probably why we don't like the CODs.
I don't know. You know, they tried that with what? What was it? Ghost? They tried it with Ghost, right? To the little horde mode thingy, whatever the heck. I don't know, man.
Wait, they did?
Yeah. In Ghost, they had that. Yeah. I'm pretty sure it was Ghost.
Dude, I didn't even play it. That's
Modern Warfare 3 had that soldier mode.
Infinity Ward.
Oh my god, bro. They were toying with us. They were testing it out to see if we would fucking do it. They were planning this shit out from the very beginning. Illuminati!
Oh my god. Edit triangles in.
Yeah, but I don't know, man. I don't know about that. But that's a good question. I don't know. Maybe some people will buy it. That game's not for me, though. Yeah, that type of... Gotcha.
How the fuck am I 1-7? What the hell? What? Uh-huh. Where the hell did that shit come from? Oh my god.
Anyway.
There's one behind me. I got one. I am dead again. Motherfucker.
I'm dead.
All right, what's the next question, Omar? Do we have another one after that?
Yeah, we have one more question. Are you guys ready for this?
Oh, cool.
Final question.
All right, the final question is, are you tired of the futuristic setting in Call of Duty?
Fuck yes. There's two people here. I'm there. Yes.
Okay. All right, go ahead, Billy. Tell us why.
Yes. I hate the new futuristic shit in Call of Duty. It's pointless. It's like normal ones, but shit. That double kill with my grenade, though.
I saw that. You took my fucking kill, bitch.
Like, I don't like futuristic shit. That's why I don't play Destiny. That's why I don't play Halo. I don't like futuristic shit, and that's why I choose not to play it. But fucking... The reason I play COD is because most of my friends play COD sort of thing, and I've just gotten good at it over time because I've played it so much now. I just can't stand the futuristic shit. I never play this unless my friends are playing this sort of thing.
Alright, Rob,
I hope they go back to Modern Warfare shit.
I'm going to be super anecdotal here and let you guys a little secret. My first Call of Duty game was on the Xbox 360, and it was the first game that I ever played as a demo at Best Buy, and that game was life-changing for me, bro. I don't know what it was, but the first game, the first Call of Duty that I played on the Xbox 360 was on Ground and World War II. And that shit was just amazing to me. I don't know what it was, but it felt so real and it felt so fucking goddamn cool to kill all the bad guys. It's like pew pew and shit. And now it just feels like I'm a robot, dude. I don't want to be a robot. I want to be a soldier. I want to be a soldier on the ground. Yeah. Being, you know, like, because I will most likely never go and get into the army because I'm a small ass motherfucker who can't even stand up for himself with other stupid ass shit. Why would I go into the military? And Call of Duty is a way for me to do that, just to exercise my fantasies, you know? And if I can't do that, then I have to be a fucking robot for 3 years now, well then shit, my fantasies aren't being lived, man. And a young boy got to live out his fantasies, you know?
What the heck?
Oh, how about you, Omar?
Keep it simple. Fuck yes. Fuck yeah, dude. I'm tired of the futuristic. I'm tired of the jetpacks. I really miss the old classic Call of Duty, man. I just miss... Oh, my God. I'm done with the futuristic settings. I don't know why they keep doing it. It's getting kind of boring. I'm tired of playing what feels like Terminator. You know, it just...
Terminator.
I'm just done. I'm done with it, bro.
I'm pretty sure it's because it sells well, but the only reason it sells well is because it's a new COD and people have to play the new COD.
And there's nothing else. There's nothing else, you know?
Yeah, it's a new COD. Buy it or you're fucking stupid. Even though there's nothing new in it.
Yeah. I just, I don't know, man. I'm done with Future State. That's all I gotta say. Is I'm done with it. Alright, guys. That's gonna do it for the Smpl crew. Rob, you wanna send it off for us?
Yeah. So, if you guys have any questions for us to answer in another video, please put that down in the comments below. If you want to input your opinions on what we said, put that in the comments down there too, because why not? We want you guys to be in on this conversation with us. So do all that stuff. We will get to you and respond to you as much as possible. And yeah, subscribe to our channel for more amazing content with Omar, Billy, Alex, and Justin, and everybody else at the Smpl Game Squad. And we'll see you guys later. Subscribe, like, and all that shit.